Our next news is out of China. More than 35 countries defend China over mass detention of Uighur Muslims in a UN letter. So, just to start this off, last week there were 22 mainly European countries that sent a letter to the UN complaining about China's human rights violations, specifically mentioning the Muslim camp that's in Xinjiang that we discussed this last year when this was coming out. They understand that there are over a million people who have been put into these camps and they want something to be done about it. Well, then this week, more than 35 countries, I think the actual number is 37, ambassadors from 37 states from Asia, Africa, Middle East, and Latin America sent letters to the UN praising China on their contribution to the international human rights cause. They said, "We note with appreciation that human rights are respected and protected in China in the process of counterterrorism and de-radicalization." So they're saying that by them imprisoning people simply for their beliefs and brainwashing them to not be Muslim anymore is a good thing, and this is just so sick.
Okay, and some of the countries, okay, so just let's just be clear. China has gotten around a million people in concentration camps for the crime of being Muslim, for just being Muslim. China has put one million people in concentration camps for being Muslim, okay? And you have a list of 35 countries saying, "Hey, good job, China, this is great for human rights," okay? And the ironic thing is two of these countries on this list are Saudi Arabia and Pakistan, right? Saudi Arabia and Pakistan are saying basically great job, China, for putting Muslims in concentration camps. I mean, I don't know where to start. Ellie, what do you make of this?
This is just sick. This is sick. I can't believe that any country, even, you know, especially Saudi Arabia and Pakistan, I understand that they have some terrible human rights violations themselves, don't get me wrong. Atheist Republic has written to the UN about Pakistan, specifically for their human rights violations. But they're a Muslim country, and they're saying this is a good thing that China is doing this?
All right. So first of all, can you clarify this? What was this part? What was this part of assigning, like, why did these 35 countries just come out and say, like, good job, China? Like, was this part of what?
Right, and that's what I was explaining in the beginning, because 22 countries, primarily from Europe, came out and said something needs to be done about China. So China was like, hey, well, here's 35. There's 35 people who agree with what we're doing.
So here's the thing. This shows the hypocrisy of the Muslim world. And also the hypocrisy of a lot of people, hashtag not all, of the Western left, okay? Because neither the most people in the Muslim world, neither the guardians of Muslims in Western countries, so the self-proclaimed guardians of minorities, neither of these groups care about Muslims. They don't care about their fellow human beings. What they do care about is being relevant and using narratives to become more powerful and have more influence. Okay? When it comes to the Muslim world, think about it. 1 million Muslims have been arrested for being Muslim. If Israel, United States did anything that was even close to a fraction of this, the entire Muslim world would have and does make sure that everybody knows about it. They would make a mess. They would be shouting this off the rooftops, okay? Because to them, they are anti-Israel, and when they are anti-Israel and anti-United States, and again, I criticize Israel all the time, but most when it comes from other places, their anti-Israel agenda is for a different reason, okay? when a lot of Muslims criticize, you know, attack United States or Israel, it's just, you know, it's just part of the narrative that they're just, you know, jumping on because it gets them to their destination, or because it gets them to the place where they want to become more influential. It's a signaling tactic to their fellow in groups, and you recognize the devil is, these are our devils, these are the signals that I need to send to show the people that I'm in and who's out, who's the enemy, who's an ally. But when it comes from China, when China does something astronomically higher, worse to Muslims than Israel and United States, not only they don't give a shit, they actually accept it, right? Again, hashtag not all. There are some Muslims that are calling bullshit on this. There are some Muslims that are trying to bring attention to this. But the true fact is that most Muslims are not paying attention to this. Most Muslims care about what Israel is doing to Palestinians or United States is doing to Muslim community in the United States, and they want to highlight that. And here's the thing, Pakistan and Saudi Arabia recognize that the powers at be are changing. You know, the United States is not as powerful as it used to be, and relatively in the international world. It's China and India are the future. And given that Saudi Arabia is learning more and more that they can't rely on United States as an ally as much as they used to, they really need to rely on China, and they are ready to throw 1 million Muslims under the bus if that means a stronger tie with China. Okay, they don't give a shit about Muslims. So when they talk about human rights in other countries, in when Saudi Arabia shits on Israel or Iran, when Pakistan talks about human, you know, the way India treats Muslims, just remember, this is just a game for them to win political scores. Because when the same countries go and say, like, hey, good job, China, that means they don't give a shit about Muslims. They're throwing 1 million Muslims under the bus because Pakistan also has a very strong economical tie right now with China, and they're not going to let anything screw that up. It's very important that by the way, this is not just Saudi Arabia and Pakistan. Other countries play this game as well. Israel, for example. Israel doesn't condemn the Armenian genocide by Turkey. Even though they said never again, even though what happened in the Holocaust, they said never again, never again, we will never forget. Now another genocide, the government of Israel, they have never come out and said, like, oh, the Armenian genocide, that was wrong, because they value their relationship with Turkey, right? So it's not about human rights for a lot of these people. It's about making political score. It's about economics. It's about making sure you have the relationships. And this is why these things need to be called out, man. This is fucking bullshit. And again, they're regressive left. Again, not all left, they're regressive left. When they say they care about Muslims, how many? So a couple of Muslims get shot in a mosque. They call it, they bring attention to it. Good, they should bring attention to it. But hundreds of thousands of Muslims get bombed in Yemen. Doesn't matter. Were they killed by white supremacists? Again, if the enemy is not, if because you have created a cult, a tribe, you have an enemy that you defined. And if your entire existence is defined based on being opposed to that enemy, that devil that you created, okay? And for these regressive leftists, it has to be a white supremacist or something, okay? If it's other Arabs bombing Arabs, they don't give a shit, even if it's 100 times more, even if it's 1,000 times more, okay? If China is putting Muslims in concentration camp, 1 million of them, they don't give a shit. It needs to be a white supremacist. And if it's just one person that being, you know, abused or oppressed by white supremacists, that matters to them a lot more than a million Muslims when it's done being done by China.
Atheists are under attack in many places. If they were Christians, their voices would be heard. If they were Jews, their voices would be heard. If they were Muslims, their voices would be heard. But they are atheists, and not many seem to be listening. Let's make it difficult for them to ignore us. We have built a global community, and now we are tearing down geographic, cultural, and language barriers so we can find each other and support each other. In the last decade, we have built the largest atheist community in the world. Now we're doing the same in other languages. With your help, we have started Atheist Republic in Persian and Arabic.
انضميت مؤخرا لأسرة Atheist Republic وحيصير عندي podcast باللغة العربية.
As we grow, we can dedicate more time, staff, and resources to start doing the same in Spanish, Portuguese, Malay, Bengali, Urdu, Hindi, and other languages. We are providing community, support, informative content, and amplifying the voices of those who need protection, especially in countries where people feel isolated simply for their lack of belief. We want to be there for them, and we are only getting started. Help us get there. Check in the description for ways you can support our projects.